Hi, and welcome to another SiteGround video. My name is Cal Evans, and in this video, we're going to look at the most common security vulnerabilities and how they're used to attack WordPress. In each case, we'll talk about things that you, the non-technical site owner, can do to protect your website. Let's get started, shall we? Now first, let's make something perfectly clear. The only way to make sure that a website is absolutely secure is to put it on its own server and erase all of the copies. Then unplug that server from the internet, unplug that server from the power, store that server safely in a closet, close and lock the door, and only you have the key. That's the only way you're going to make sure that a website is absolutely secure. In other words, websites are vulnerable, and there will always be security threats. But there are also absolute must-take steps that you, the website owner, should do to make sure that your website is as secure as possible. Is WordPress secure? This is a very common question. WordPress is a great platform to build almost any website on top of. But, like every other piece of software ever written, some bugs will get released. Now, these bugs could expose new security vulnerabilities. But that's not just WordPress. There are hundreds of programs at play anytime you serve up even a single web page. A vulnerability in any of these programs could be just the vulnerability that a bad actor needs. WordPress is a popular tool for building websites. Because of this, it's a very popular target for attacks. But this doesn't mean that WordPress is a bad choice for building websites. Every platform out there can and will be attacked. Thankfully, because WordPress is so popular, there's a large number of people out there already looking at how it's being attacked and looking for solutions for us. Let's have a look now at the most common security issues related to WordPress and how to mitigate them. So, the first vulnerability on our list is having out-of-date core software. A common problem with websites is that there are so many moving parts behind the scenes, not just programs, but libraries as well, that can provide an in for a bad actor. Large websites employ entire teams of system administrators, or sysadmins, to keep everything patched and running on all the servers it requires to serve that site. Most smaller companies can't afford even a single full-time sysadmin, so this is one of the things that bad actors look for, out-of-date software. Luckily, this is an easy one to fix. If you have a top-tier hosting partner like SiteGround, they employ a large team of sysadmins that monitor security bulletins as part of their daily routine. When a patch comes out for a program or a library, they swing into action. They patch a test system, run tests to make sure that this doesn't break anything else, and then they start rolling this patch out to across the entire infrastructure. On any given day, there are multiple patches rolling out just to keep your website safe. For the most part, you probably can't affect the core software that runs your website. That usually takes a system administrator. You can, however, make sure that WordPress and all the plugins and themes are upgraded. Every piece of software has bugs, and this includes WordPress, and yes, it includes your favorite plugin or your favorite theme. The problem is that we don't know about these bugs yet. As these bugs become known, software teams swing into action to patch the problem and release an update so that your site can be that much safer. This requires you to do your part. You have to regularly update everything and make sure that everything is on automatic update. Because these days, WordPress does have the automatic update system, and that helps keep the core of WordPress and all of your themes and plugins up to date. However, there is a delay between the time that the update is released and the time that the updater will pull it down to you. If you log in and notice that your site has plugins, themes, or the core WordPress that are ready to be updated, take a minute, click the update button, and go ahead and make your site that much more secure. Brute force attacks are exactly what they sound like. Someone has a script and they point it at a website. This script does nothing more than try all the popular usernames and passwords until it finds a hit. Users who use the same username and password on multiple websites make this attack possible. Now, as soon as a site is compromised and the logins and passwords are downloaded, they're sold to other bad actors who then load them into their scripts and point them at other websites, hoping that somebody has reused a login and a password. Now, there are a couple of ways to stop a brute force attack. First, use a good security plugin. Now, since they're usually trying the same login and a different password, you use a plugin like SiteGround's security plugin to limit the number of times they can try a given username with a password. The SiteGround security plugin defaults to 5. If I'm the only user on my website, say my personal blog, I usually cut that down to 3 because if I can't remember my password in 3 tries, something's wrong. Now, the other way is what we call brute force mitigation. There are systems out there that track where brute force attacks come from. And when they see traffic coming from one of these computers that they've already identified coming to your website, they simply block it. Top-tier hosts like SiteGround have brute force mitigation built into their platform. If you're unsure, ask your host. Malware is any piece of malicious software that a bad actor can inject into your site and run whenever they want. Malware can be injected as easily as a properly formatted comment or as difficult as a file uploaded that can be executed. No matter how the malware gets on your site, once it's there, it's bad. In the best scenario, the malware won't actually cause you problems, but it will display things like ads for other products to your customers. This is pretty easy to clean. A much worse case scenario, though, is someone that injects something into your site that allows them to run programs on your server. These programs do things like create accounts on the WordPress site, or worse yet, create user accounts on the underlying operating system. These scenarios are much harder to clean and usually involve restoring your site from a clean backup and then figuring out how they did it and patching that hole. Even then, you can only hope you got all of it. This is why malware scanners and cleaning services are such good investments for any WordPress site. There are many good services out there that will help you by scanning your site on a regular basis for known malware. When found, they identify the malware and either take action automatically or recommend a course of action for you to clean your site. Many of the best web hosting partners have malware scanners that can operate at a level that plugins just can't. Because your web host has access to the infrastructure below your site, it can not only tell you if there's a problem there, but it can also see if any damage was done at that level. This gives you a little bit extra layer of security. Make sure that you employ some kind of malware scanning on your site. Also, make sure that you back up your site on a regular basis and keep 30 days of backups available to you. This way, if you have to restore your site from a backup, you can probably go far enough back to get a clean version. Denial of service, or DOS, and distributed denial of service, or DDoS, attacks are very similar in nature. The basic premise of the attack is that someone runs a script that requests pages from your server faster than your server can actually serve them. In a DDoS attack, it's actually more than one person or computer, and they're usually spread out geographically. Now, caching services help mitigate DDoS attacks. If you're worried about being attacked with DDoS, make sure that your system has a solid caching system in front of it. Most top-tier websites have DDoS mitigation systems built into their infrastructure. Most of them will tell you if they do, but don't expect them to tell you exactly what they do. This helps keep the bad actors guessing. The good news is these types of attacks won't leak your users' data. Now, I know that doesn't help when your website's down for days at a time. Phishing attacks come in a lot of different styles. They have names like catfishing and spear phishing. We're going to lump all of these into one big overall group called phishing because they share a lot of commonalities. Basically, a phishing attack is when someone sends an email that looks like it came from your server to a user and asks them to click a link and do something. The link may look like it's going to your website, but in reality, it's going to a website owned by the bad actor. The most common form of this attack displays a login page like on your website. A user not paying attention may enter their login credentials into the bogus form. Now, at this point, since it's not actually your website, it won't log the user in. Now, clever bad actors tell the users that those are invalid credentials and ask them to try again. Unsuspecting users may try several different sets of credentials before they either catch on or just give up. The end result is the bad actor now has multiple username and password combinations that they can use when brute forcing other websites, as well as the proper credentials for logging into your website. Now, phishing attacks are a little bit more difficult to mitigate. Because of the way that email was originally designed, it's real easy to fake where an email says it comes from. These days, however, thanks to technologies like SPF, DKIM, or DMARC, email servers can check where an email came from and whether that's a valid source for your domain. If you've got these set up properly and someone sends a phishing attack to your customers, the server receiving the email can verify the email source and act accordingly. It can either mark it as spam or quarantine it. If you're not sure if you have SPF, DKIM, and DMARC set up properly, ask your web host. Most top-tier web hosts have easy-to-follow instructions on how to set these up. There's a reason I regularly refer to the company charged with hosting your website as your web hosting partner. They are responsible for a large part of what keeps your site up, operational, and safe. Yeah, you can get web hosting for free, or as little as $5 a year. Those solutions are worth every penny you pay for them. If your website is important to you or your users, you want to look for someone you can trust. Someone with a good reputation in the industry. Someone who has a deep knowledge of WordPress. Someone who adapts the latest technology and actively reacts to threats. Someone who has top-tier support for those times when things go wrong. In short, you need to look for a web hosting partner like SiteGround, where you get all of the tools and features you need to keep your website safe and secure. Look, no website connected to the internet is ever going to be 100% secure. The secret to keeping your site as secure as possible is to stay vigilant and to build your security in layers. Malware scanning, regular backups, regularly scheduled updates of all systems. These are three good layers to start building your foundation for a more secure website. Remember, the goal's not to be 100% secure, because you can't do that unless the server is locked in that closet we talked about. What you want to do is make your site more trouble to the bad actor than the next site on their list. Be difficult enough, and they'll usually move on to that next website. Hey, I want to thank you for watching this video today. I hope you found it informative and useful. If you like this video, click the subscribe button below and hit the bell icon. This way, we'll let you know anytime new videos are released. Also, follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram to stay up to date with all the news happening around SiteGround. We'll see you on the next video.